So we're going to demonstrate how we're going to collect photosynthesis measurements for this lab and provide data that you're going to then interpret. So this unit I'm holding in my hand here is a newer sensor technology that measures proxy measurements for photosynthesis. So normally, my first research job, I measured photosynthesis with an instrument about 15 times this size. There was an infrared gas analyzer that actually measured the carbon dioxide drawdown of the leaf. So it clamped onto the leaf like we're going to here and actually measured the gas exchange in the whole process of photosynthesis. But now we have some technologies, and now that we understand the process of photosynthesis as well as we do, this instrument here, developed by researchers at Michigan State University, is able to, if we push the button here and actually open this door, there's a little window in here that actually sends a bunch of pulses of light of different wavelengths. So we're sending photosynthetically active radiation as well as different wavelengths to the leaf surface and measuring the reflectance, the absorbance, and the fluorescence of those light bands and the intense based on the intensity of that light. And using those responses of the leaf, then it actually can calculate an estimate of photosynthesis. So the other piece it has is this circle on the front here. This is an ambient light sensor. So it's measuring how much incoming irradiance there is, or light intensity. And that way it uses that as an estimate as in the calculations also of photosynthesis. So what we're gonna do for this lab activity is we are going to provide you with some field measurements using this instrument. And it is all connected via Bluetooth to an app on a phone. And so here I can start. We've pre-programmed our phone with a set of questions. Is it a C3 or a C4 crop? Hopefully at this point we know that corn is a C4 crop. Is it a sun or a shade leaf? Our light intensity isn't so high right now, but this is generally a sunny leaf. And then also, what crop is it? And so we have all that pre-programmed in here, so it's then going to be linked to the data. And then what we do is we open this up, clamp it onto the leaf, and tell this to measure. What it's doing inside that little pulse, I'm trying to hold my hand as steady as I can. It's measuring incoming radiation levels from the sky. It's emitting beams of light inside that little window onto the surface of the leaf and measuring the reflectance. So it can measure both photosynthesis, so the energy traveling through the photosynthesis systems 1 and 2, as well as the chlorophyll content of the leaf. So it's also going to give us some estimates of the chlorophyll content of the leaf, which is basically indicated by the greenness and the absorb or the reflectance of those green wave bands. So it takes about 15 seconds for it to run through its measurements, and then it will pop up with some data on the screen here. And then once we get back into the lab, we can upload it once we get onto a network. And so right here, it'll show the actual data. And there's a screen here that has ambient temperature, humidity, chlorophyll content, our PAR level, which is our photosynthetically active radiation, as well as the stability of those measurements. And I can accept that, and then that will be uploaded later to the web, and we will share this data with you. So we're going to take measurements on sun leaves, shade leaves of both C3 and C4 crops, and then you will be able to interpret and analyze that data and see if it fits with your understanding of those different photosynthesis systems.